Christ living undivided right.
You need a strong east wind. You need a strong east wind to blow out your preconceived ideas. You need a strong east wind to blow out your religion. You need a strong east wind to blow out the doctrine of the scribes and Pharisees, which still possess your soul because you've not allowed the Holy Ghost to move in you and set you free.
A ministry with a vision. A ministry on the move. A ministry established by our faith in the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Think what God wants to do in his people is make his supernatural Holy Ghost fire and power clear to our sight, clear to our mind, so that there is no doubt in our spiritual creation who God is.
Revival for Christ Love International Ministry, a ministry with a vision built on a plan. God.
See, if you're going to get dressed for battle, you got to get delivered. You got to get redeemed. You got to get established in spiritual soundness of a mind of state of deliverance. Then you freely operate in righteousness.
You are part of a vision, and that vision is going to spread fire. It's going to spread fire.
You will start to produce a roar out of the sea, not just their roar, but a roar that came from the Lion of Judah. The roar out of that came from the Word, and it came from the Spirit.
They went into that fire wearing a special garment. It's time for you to walk through the furnace with the robe of righteousness.
We proclaim Jesus Christ as King and Lord of the night. Jesus Christ, King and Lord of all! Satan, you have no power.
In the center of the caverns of hell, hidden under layers of evil that have thrived for centuries, sets the morbid domain of the Prince of the Power of the Air. Suddenly, a scaly creature disrupts Satan's ghastly existence with an urgent message. It reads, Code Red Problem. Conference needed. Disaster forecasted. With a disgusted annoyance, this general of evil agrees to confer with his chief demon lieutenant. This is the story of that encounter.
Lord Satan.
State your business and make it fast.
Sir, we're having problems of cataclysmic proportions.
Where?
In the East Sector, sir, the damage is vast.
Is there something wrong with my abortion clinics?
Well, no, sir. That's all fine. We kill 4,000 unborn a day through, shall we say, surgical removal?
Good.
It's selective breeding. We eliminate human life in the name of convenience, like the Nazis and the Jews and with the government's approval.
Is there a problem? Project television violence.
Sir, it's covered from videos to cartoons. By the time a child graduates high school, he's seen 70,000 murders.
Is this effective enough?
Sir, just watch the news.
Is there a disturbance in my false religion?
Oh, no, sir. Business is booming. Over 40 million are into New Age and Zen. Over 45 million believe in astrology.
Looks like we are catching up.
Yes, sir. Only 50 million claim to be born again.
Is there a problem with business in general?
Sir, we're showing tremendous progress.
Yes.
Teenage runaways, each year a million or more. There's a teen suicide every 90 minutes. And your specialty, drunk driving,
yes,
will claim more lives this year than the whole Vietnam War.
Well, is there a disturbance? What was that?
Sir, that's the reason all these demons are on crutches and wobbling.
What's going on?
Sir, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
What is that?
Sir, that is our problem.
Only one thing causes warfare. of this magnitude.
Then, sir, you know what we are dealing with up there.
Yes, it's some of those sanctified.
Try, blood-bought. Saints of God.
Actually,
presently on their knees. In prayer. Sir, they're literal holy terrors. They bind us, cast us out. Then they do those disgusting charismatic jinks. They quote scriptures like the Son of God, and sir, if you don't intervene, we all might wind up in a bunch of pigs. Sir, that's the good news. The bad news is the subject of their prayers that threatens our survival. What they're praying for is causing hemorrhaging in the realms of darkness. Sir, they're praying for revival.
It's hardly controllable. At the Assisi Street outpouring, things got rough.
Yes, sir. And when the charismatic movement hit, sir, we were jumping out of windows. With all of that, untie my bow tie. Who stole my hand of stuff?
Then I'll come in like a flood.
But they'll say the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against you. It's written in the Word.
But for weapons against
you. Sir, no weapon formed against them shall prosper. That's in the Bible, too.
Yes, I heard. I'll hate them with every filthy, lusty fuck you can imagine.
But it's written, resist the devil and he must flee.
Obviously, the enemy is taking the power more seriously than we are.
And that's very dangerous, sir. And especially for me.
Time to launch my final most vicious attack. I'll remind the saints of their past. How they were liars, cheaters, manipulators, and mortals.
But sir, you know what will happen if you remind the saints of their past.
And what is that?
Sir, they'll just remind you of your future.
No!
Attention all saints of God, man your battle stations. Sound the alarm loud and long. All men of every nation, we're kicking down the gates of hell, not stopping to their level. For the sentence of destruction's on the forehead of the devil. Lift your hands in victory, this is our finest hour. For the sleeping giant called the church is rising up in power. Cry loud, spare not, this lion's gonna roar. We may have lost some battles, but we will win this war.
Get ready for the moving of the Spirit of the Lord. Revival is coming to our land. The Holy Ghost is moving like a hurricane. Revival is coming to our shores. Get ready for the moving of the Spirit of the Lord. Revival is coming to our land. The Holy Ghost is moving like a hurricane. Revival is coming to our shores. Get ready for the moving of the Spirit of the Lord. From Africa to Spain, from Mexico to China, the Spirit of God is being poured out on all flesh, and there's revival in the land.
Welcome to the Knights of the Lord's Table Month and Octoberfest Revival. Are you ready for revival today? Oh, come on. Are you ready for revival? Are you ready to shout? Are you ready to dance? Are you ready to praise the name of the Lord? Welcome to Revival for Christ Club, Octoberfest Revival, here at the club, Christ Living and Undivided Bride. Amen. Again, welcome out. Let's go ahead and get this service started off the right way. Let's go before the Lord in a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you. And Father, we come with an expectation. Father, we come with an excitement, Father. Lord, we come with passion, Father. For Lord, we look to you this night. We look to you during this revival. And Father, we ask you, Lord, to move by your Spirit, God. Lord, move by your power. Father, we ask you, Lord, to pour out your presence upon this place today. For Lord, we are here for one reason. We have gathered and come together for one reason, in one name, and that is the name of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise this night. And Father, we ask all this in the name of your precious Son, Jesus. And the whole church said, amen. Let's praise the name of the Lord.
Oh, come on, we can do a tiny bit better than that. This is RFC, and we're in Octoberfest Revival. I better hear somebody shout for Jesus today.
Glory.
Glory. Hallelujah.
This is what we come to do.
We come to tear down strongholds, break the chain.
Bind the devil.
Bind the devil in Jesus' name.
Tonight,
we got a right to shake the foundation with praise.
Come on, somebody, glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
What you come to do?
This is what we come to do.
We come to tear down strongholds,
break the chains.
Bind the devil
in Jesus' name.
Yes, tonight.
Tonight, we got a right to shake the foundation with praise.
Glory.
Praise him.
The Lord is worthy.
The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy.
He's so worthy.
The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy.
Tonight.
Tonight.
We got a right
to shake the foundation with praise.
Somebody. Glory.
Hallelujah.
This is what
we've come to do. Tear down strongholds, break the chains.
Bind the devil.
Bind the devil in Jesus' name.
Tonight.
Tonight. We got a right to shake the foundation with
sing
praise.
It again. Glory.
Glory. Hallelujah.
This is what
we come to do.
Did you come to tear down strongholds,
break the chains,
and bind the devil?
Bind the devil in Jesus' name.
Tonight.
Tonight. We got a right to shake the foundation with praise.
Praise him.
Praise him.
Lord is worthy.
The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy.
So worthy.
The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy.
Tonight.
Tonight. We got a right to shake the foundation with praise.
Praise him. Come on, let's praise him.
Praise him.
The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy. The Lord is worthy.
Tonight.
Tonight. We got a right to shake the foundation with praise.
Glory.
Glory.
Hey.
Hallelujah.
What you come to do?
This is what we come to do.
We come to tear
down strongholds, break the chain.
Bind them up.
Bind the devil in Jesus' name.
Tonight. We got a night to shake the foundation with praise.
Praise him. Come on, let's praise him.
Praise him.
Did you come to praise him?
Praise
lift him, lift him, lift him, lift him.
Praise him.
Come on and lift him
praise
up.
Praise him.
Come on and lift him
praise
up.
Praise him.
If you got breath, come on.
Praise him.
One more time.
Tonight, we got a right
to shake the foundation with praise. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I want to thank everyone for coming out. out to October Revival. It's going to be an amazing and an awesome time in the Lord. I can already feel His Spirit and His anointing. Don't let it stop. Let it continue moving in your lives. Keep speaking in tongues. Let the Spirit keep moving. Woo! But first, what I want to do, as praise just ended, I want to welcome up a new team that just came out. A new team that's ready, that's on fire for the Lord. They may be young, but they got a young lion's roar. So give it up for the young lions as they come out to do consuming fire. This is a branch of the Winds of Fire flag team.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
God, I want you guys to know they actually just learned that flag routine yesterday. So that was awesome. That was amazing. Well, what I want to do real quick, because you saw these young men that were up here. They just didn't come up here just because one day they're like, oh, I'm deciding I'm going to go flag and worship the Lord. No, they had women and men who were leaders before them, who led them the right way. So right now, I want to give honor to the ministers that are in Revival for Christ Club in this place today. First, I want to start honoring our amazing Pastor Chris. He is there for everyone when they are in need. Whenever their souls are in trouble, there he is because he is always there watching over the flock and the sheep. This is our amazing and lovely Pastor Chris Colley. Next, I want to honor his amazing and wonderful wife, Alethea Colley. She is our evangelist here at Revive for Christ Club. She is always proclaiming and preaching the word of God with fire, breaking the chains and breaking the things and the shackles that have been holding God's people back. I want you to know she has an amazing Oil of Freedom class that if you were to go to, I promise you, your chains would be broken. I promise you that. Next, I want to do is honor our prophetess, Sandra. She is actually my aunt, but I most importantly remember as our prophetess. She always is there preaching and ministering the word of God to God's people. She never speaks until God tells her to speak. So if you want to know what God has to say, listen closely with your ears and listen to the fire that comes out of the mouth of your prophets that are revived for Christ's love. And next I want to honor is a minister, Karen. She is a wonderful and amazing minister. I want you guys to know something. This minister is a new minister, but I promise you this, she has wisdom inside of her heart that God has placed in her. Because I know there's a lot of people that come in here with a lot of bit of issues or people that come in who she's never even met before. And God will say, let me use my minister, Karen, to minister to those people and give wisdom into their lives that they may walk in God's freedom. All right, I want to honor one of my favorite ministers here. He's one of those walkers. He walks just like this. And I would say he walks like that in the spirit, just to let you know. This is minister, our prophet, John Crandall. He's an amazing minister who has the fire of God inside of his heart. And guess what? This is the thing right about Prophet Crandall. I want to share some personal things about him. This man right here, even though he's dealing with cancer inside of his body, but I want you to know something. There are people that go to him because of the smile that is on his face. There are people that go to him because of the fire that comes out of his mouth. And there are people that go to him because there's a sweet oil that comes off Prophet Crandall whenever he's proclaiming and prophesying to God's people. That's what I love to see in this place. We never discriminate. We never put people down. We see the ability and opportunity in every single vessel. That's the vision we have at Revive for Christ Club. Next I want to honor is our Pastor Mark. He is an amazing pastor. He takes care of everything around Revive for Christ. He's always taking care of the church. He has always been there for every single person that is in here. And I will say this about Pastor Mark. No matter what it is, no matter what he's doing, he always has a good attitude and always shares the word of God to any of the sheep in a flock that are wandering around the area. Oops, excuse me there. And I want to honor this new minister. Did I get all the ministers over here? Where's Pastor Abel at? There he is. Oh, Pastor Fuego. We can't get about Pastor Fuego. This guy right here, oh, Ronda de Sea, back in our theater, I want you guys to know something. In that moment, whenever he was preaching and ministering, it was like fire fell down and began to fill up the area. It was like a fire, wildfire spreading across. I saw souls get ignited. I saw souls get set free through the fire that is at Pastor Abel. And I promise you this, he actually also starts our Spanish church here at Revive for Christ Love. We're not only reaching just here, but we're trying to reach around the globe, spreading the fire across the nation. And Bishop Sanders, where's Mr. Bishop Sanders? Mr. Bishop Sanders right here. Everyone get a round of applause for Bishop Sanders. Bishop Sanders has an amazing testimony coming from a place where he was dealing with drugs and all these different things. Now he is someone who sets people away from drugs. He is one who sets people away and sets them free from the things that were once holding them back. He broke the chains of Egypt, and now he is proclaiming God's word to God's people across the world. Okay, is that almost all the other ministers? I think I got through them all. Now I want to get to our newest minister here, Minister Mario Johnson. He's an amazing man of God. I want you guys to know this. He is someone who's taken God's word seriously. Ever since he was the age of 9, he always took God's word seriously. He had a decision that he had to make at a young age, and he was right here in this church. And when he made that decision, God completely changed his life, and he began moving forward, leading the MITs where they're supposed to be, showing us example what it means to be a minister of the Lord and listening to the voice of our apostles. Now I want to get to our apostles. First, I want to give great honor to Apostle Jenni. She is She has preached God's word without hesitation. She's preached God's words with boldness. She didn't care what the world had to say about her. She didn't care what the world said about her behind her back. But she said, I know my God will protect me. I know my God has me. I am a woman of God who loves my Savior. And she always was there for Revival Christ, up leading them in the right way. And then I want to give honor to her visionary, Chief Apostle Timothy Vanover, who had the vision at the age of 12 and felt the fire inside of his heart to start a vision that was spread across the nation that brings us all here, that we all are here today. Every single one of us come from the vision that God placed in Chief Apostle's heart when he was only 12 years old. And now I would like to bring up a minister in training, Erin Moss, as she comes to give us a little delivery of someone special she's about to bring up.
Thank you, MIT JJ. All right, who's excited to be in the house of the Lord? Woo! It's Octoberfest, y'all. I'm so pumped. I'm so excited. I'm ready to give the devil two black eyes, show him what we're about, show him who RFC is. So tonight, I have an incredible opportunity. I'm so excited. When Minister Mario asked me, I was like, yes, thank you for the opportunity. So I want to pay honor to our Minister Mario. Thank you so much for asking me. But I get to introduce tonight's speaker. I'm so excited. I was praying to the Lord, and I was like, Lord, what can I say? How can I honor this incredible man of God? And it's easy to look at the physical because he is my brother. But I want to talk about some spiritual elements that he carries inside of him. And things that I have had the privilege to see over the last 31 years, not only is he faithful to this ministry and to our leadership, but he is also a mini fire starter, a defender, loyal, prayerful, uses the word and the spirit. He doesn't, whenever he opens up his mouth, it's not what he has to say, but only what God gives him. If you've ever heard him speak, it's seasoned of the Lord. I'm so excited. I know God has something very special that he's placed on his heart tonight. And I pray each and every person came in ready, came in hungry for this amazing vessel of God. So if you're not standing to your feet and you're able, come on, stand up to your feet. Let's give reverence to the Lord as I introduce this amazing, mighty man of God, MIT Darrio Moss.
Come on, saints of God! Ah! Do you believe what God has placed inside of you? Do you believe that you can win tomorrow and on the 31st? You are to be equipped. The Lord said tonight to equip his people with that armor. Not just any armor, that armor of light. That armor of light is what we shall be equipped with and unashamed to carry, not just for this month, but every single day. Because the days are darker, and it's time for the true believers, the true worshipers, the ones that truly carry the light, to spread it everywhere, to spread that fire. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this opportunity. God, I give you thanks. Nothing I do tonight is of me, but I pray every bit of what I do is in obedience to what the flow of the anointing desires to do. Let me start this revival off right, flowing in your anointing, flowing in your spirit. Let me speak only what you would have me to speak. Let not one thing that I do be out of the flow, but everything said, everything done in the flow of your anointing. And let us all go from here today prepared to fight. Prepared for battle. You entrusted us with this. You gave us a fivefold that equipped us. And now we take tonight as the day of preparation for the battle ahead. The enemy thinks he has something on us just because our chief apostle and our apostle Jenni aren't here. But I believe that I am in a ministry equipped for the battle.
Equip them for the battle tonight, Lord. And all glory and all honor goes to you, what's done tonight. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. I say, and we all say, amen and amen. Tonight, the Lord told me, just while I was in the middle of Ubering, that we need to be equipped. I hope you have been preparing your vessel. Because tonight, once I'm done with this message, if you need to be equipped, if you've been struggling, then now is your time to get back into focus. Because we don't need any weak links when we get ready to fight. Because you know the enemy's gonna come. He knows with them being gone. He did it last time whenever Ron was in charge. And you dang sure better be believing that he's gonna try to do it again. Just because our visionary's not here. But I believe that you all have the ability. You all have been equipped with the power. You all have that light. You're not walking in darkness. And I hope that you embrace the light every single day. Every single day, embrace that light. There's two different type of words that we can walk around with in this day and age. We know all about them. That word over here, that word over there. One of righteousness and one of religiosity. Religiosity is just in darkness that tries to masquerade as the light. But the righteousness over here, the word of righteousness over here contains a people that are humble. They're humble and know that what they have is not of them. What they can do is not by anything that they can do, not by might, not by power, but by the spirit that is within them. Meanwhile, over here, they're in the darkness. But I'm praying and believing that there's coming a day right now where the real people, the real warriors of light are standing up. And they're gonna let the world know what it truly means to follow after God. Not following some rigid guidelines, trying to play being holy, but flowing by the anointing, flowing by the Spirit in everything that they do. Practicing godliness, like I talked about in Sunday school. Like it says in 1 Timothy. Physical training is good for a little bit. But godliness, that spiritual training, is good for everything and in every situation. You want to walk around unashamed. Do not be ashamed of him, because he'll be ashamed of you. You are equipped with that light. The very first thing that God said in the Bible, he said, let there be light. And that light that's going to be inside of you has two elements that will light up and make your armor brighter and brighter. That word and that spirit. Jesus said, as he said in John 8:12, then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. And you know what's happening in this time of year. We're not blind to what's going on. We're not blind to the fact that the enemy is trying to bring darkness into this city, into El Dorado, in across the entire world. We have been fighting for as long as I have been here to preserve that light. Even those that might walk in ignorance or even stupidity, because they should know better if they call themselves believers. But even still, we protect them because we care about them, because we truly love them. Far be it from us to just walk around and not share the truth with them. I am so grateful that I had the opportunity to go out on Street Warriors just recently. And I saw indeed warriors who walked unashamed, who walked equipped. I saw it in Minister Karen. I saw it in Tina. I saw it in Ryan. I saw it in JJ. I saw it in all of us, especially when we were standing outside of that circus. And we did not care that there was people in the car just across from us. We loudly proclaim the name of Jesus. We loudly proclaim his light. Because just like in John 1 and 5, the light always shines in the darkness. The darkness will never overcome it. You have that light that will expose those walking in the darkness, and it will be a beacon that will draw those that want to be out of the darkness, that are searching. They need that light in each and every one of you. You have been tasked. While you're still here, there's hope. There's an assignment for you. There's at least somebody out there that needs what you have. You could be the only Jesus that somebody comes across. Why are you taking the armor off? Why are you taking that armor off? But you need to be equipped, not just for the end of this month, but for every single day, to bring everyone out of the darkness that is called to walk that narrow path. Be not unashamed, because otherwise, when you're walking over here with this word, you instead have pride. And we've been told around here, God doesn't like pride. He hates a proud look, because we know who had that proud look in the beginning, and that was Satan. Instead, when you walk around and you have an armor of darkness, a facade. Instead of having a helmet of salvation, you'll have a helmet of selfishness. Because his word says that God knows the thoughts of man and their vanity. They're nothing, and they're in an excess of pride, thinking they are above. The natural man cannot comprehend the things of God, for their foolishness to him. And when you walk around, you don't have a breastplate of righteousness. You have a breastplate of self-righteousness, where you determine what it is without letting yourself be led by that real word over there. You put on airs. Instead, you are being like those Sadducees and the Pharisees back then, who had dead man's bones inside of them. They put on their robes, they put on their outer garments, and they look like their righteousness, but they have nothing to offer. Nothing to offer for the spirit, nothing to offer for the people. And when you walk around girded, you're not girded in truth, you're girded in my truth. And the power of life and death comes from the tongue. And what you speak out, instead of giving life, will corrupt and lead someone to death, lead someone into that darkness. When your feet are shod, they're not shod in the preparation of peace. They're shod in the preparation of offense. You're looking for everything, every transgression that you think in your own self-righteous, selfish mind. You think that you are your own God, and anyone that does not conform to the way you think ought to be put to death. They don't want to say that out there in this day and age, but we know how they think. They think that they can control what God made them to be. He knew them before they formed in the womb. And now they want to stand and walk in that pride, thinking they understand themselves better than they understand the one that created them in the cool of the day. And when you've got a shield, it's not a shield of faith. It's a shield of rebellion. And as we know, rebellion is like a sin unto witchcraft. And that is indeed what is going to be kicked up the most during this time of year. Rebellion against the Lord. Rebellion against the light. Trying to consume the light. And lastly, this sword is not of the spirit. It's a sword of religion, a sword of ceremonies, a sword that just cuts one way. It's not two-edged. It's a sword that says, I'm going to pass judgment, but I don't pass judgment on myself. Because I follow my ceremonies, I am already holy. And because I follow my ceremonies, I get to cast judgment upon you for not following what I follow. But it's time to stand with the real armor. Like it says in Romans 13 and 12, if you'll go there right now. The night is far spent. The day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. in the Amplified, it says the night is far gone and the day is almost here. Let us drop, fling away the deeds of darkness and put on the full armor of light. When you walk in that light, you have nothing to be ashamed of. Just like Adam and Eve, like it said at the end of Genesis 2, they stood before one another and they were not ashamed. You know why? Because even though they might be naked physically, spiritually, they had on their royal garments. They had on that armor that God had already equipped them with. And the second they sinned, that's when it got taken right off of them. And they perceived themselves as they were in the physical. And Revelation 16:15 says that Jesus said that I come like a thief in the night. Let's turn there real quick. He said, I'm reading the Amplified. And this red letter edition too in the King James, so you ain't got any reason to argue with this. Behold, I am going to come like a thief. Blessed, happy to be envied, is he who stays awake, alert, and who guards his clothes so that he may not be naked and have the shame of being seen exposed. I can recall earlier this year I saw a video of an African warlock who was saved and delivered. He talked about during his time when he was involved with that wickedness. He went into a church and saw a man of God. And by the spiritual works that he was operating by, he could see that man completely in the nude. Because that right there was just this religion. You think you have what you need, but in reality, you're completely exposed. And you're just a puppet on the string for the enemy to use. But now it's time. Now it's time to not only just have on the armor of light, but to keep on that armor every single day. Because you can't sit around, like it says in 1 John 1 and 5, you can't tell yourself that you're with the light and then participate still in the darkness. Now is not a time for compromise. Now is a time for you to make a decision. Compromise is for the lukewarm. Compromise is for those who want to think they got all the time in the world. But remember, life is but a vapor to our God. The days are short. Don't waste your time continuously letting in that thing that kept wrecking your house. Don't continuously let in those thoughts that are completely screwing you up and causing you to lose whatever momentum you have in God. You start gaining ground. You start doing what God's needing you to do. You're headed for the tabernacle, but then like a bungee cord, it just pulls you right back to the camp. It's time to cut off that cord. It's time to cut it off. Stop holding on to those things on the wall, just like Marissa was talking about. Don't be admiring them. Get rid of them. Throw them in the fire. Stay in the fire. Because we got to get to that furnace walk. We're all going to have it at some point. And you need that fire, that light of the fire. Because we know back in the day, they didn't have electricity back then. So how do they see everything? By fire. By fire. You need that equal measure of the word and of the spirit so that your armor can have its full luster that shines brighter and brighter. Because without one or the other, it's just a dull bit of religiosity. We're not in religiosity. We're also not in spiritual cosmicness. We're in the flow of the anointing. We're in obedience, following the whole word of God and letting that Holy Ghost illuminate it with the salt so that you can see how it applies in your life, how it will enhance you. It's not time for compromise. We're done with that. If we want to get to the 40, we got to give everything to him. Throw it in the fire. Let it go. Throw it in the fire. Let it go. Throw it in the fire. Let it go. Throw it in the fire. It's time for you to be equipped. a new sword, a new shield, girded with a new truth, feet shod, a new helmet, and a breastplate. The whole armor! The whole armor! No more games! No more! Pastor Chris was said it through, God said it through Pastor Chris, no more! How long will you hold between two opinions? No more! No more! We are in a day and age where the influence of devil busting is going to a new city. And next year, it'll be another city. And then not long after that, more cities will open up. I believe we're gonna see that day where we're gonna have devil busting coast to coast. And maybe after that, around the entire world. So that the enemy has no place he can hide. The light will shine in that darkness and will expose those wickedness. It'll expose that wickedness. Those walking in wickedness, they don't want to get into the light. But I believe there's even more believers out there. And you have a part in that, in finding those that want the light. That aren't ashamed to stand before the Lord and expose everything. And say, Lord, whatever I have to do to be in right standing with you, whatever I need to do to be in your obedience, I give everything up, and I want all of you. We need to stop playing games, and I'm speaking to myself just as much as anybody else. The enemy's trying to fight me hard because he knows what I'm capable of for the end of this month. He's going to fight you because he knows what you're capable of. I can't do this on my own. Me, JJ, and Mara, we can't do this on their own. We need all of you. We need all of you in one mind, one spirit, one accord. There will be no weakly care. There will be no weakly care. Every single one of you has a part. You are chosen for him. Don't lose sight of that. Like I was talking about with the club in Sunday school, you have exclusive access. You have exclusive access to a well. And then you take what you gained, and you spread it to as many people as you can. Don't shy away from the truth. Don't shy away from showing your light. Who cares if they get offended at you? Who cares if they don't like you? The ones that truly need that truth, they will seek you out. I want to be like those four Hebrew boys, not just Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, but like Daniel. When we're in that day and age where they're trying to outlaw what we do, you know what we're going to do? Open up the windows and then loudly proclaim that greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. We ain't here to be friends with the world. Anybody that's a friend of the world is an enemy to God. Understand that. It doesn't matter how few of us there might be. The truth can stand 10 toes down on its own. Doesn't need backup. That's why they want to hide behind their rebellion and in their offense, because they think they have all the numbers. They think they have the people that makes them right. It doesn't matter. The Lord is greater than all of that. Because God can do exceedingly and abundantly above everything you could ask or think of. The enemy likes to, he's maybe called the God of this world, but there's nothing in here that God can't give us access to. There's no place we can't go. God opens those doors. And now it's time for you to walk with that light. Don't be ashamed of the light. Embrace that light. Stop using this to try and understand how to work with God. Stop using this. You may have a nice idea here or there. You may think you understand how things are supposed to work. But you need to submit yourself every single day. submit yourself to the will of God. That's the most important thing. Maybe that idea might be for another time. Maybe it's not needed at all. But nevertheless, thy will be done. Nevertheless, thy will be done concerning whatever you need me to do, Lord. Many plans a man might have, but it's the purpose of God that will come alive, that will come to fruition in them. Are you going to let that come alive in you? Are you going to allow him to give you that victory? Do you believe already that we have the victory? I've been listening to Never Lost by C.C. Winans, and I love the part where she says, I don't have to wait till the battle's over. I can shout now! Shout! Proclaim victory! It's yours for the taking! It's yours for the taking! We're not going to tiptoe around. We're not going to dip our feet. We're going to jump right in. We're coming full force for the enemy. We're saying, devil, we're not backing down from you. We have that armor of light. We are living in God's holy truth from day to day. Time to get equipped. It's time to get equipped. If you need to be equipped, if you need to be equipped, just come and pray at the altar. Ask for it. You need to be equipped. I don't have to touch you, but just ask the Lord to equip you, that he give you what you need for tomorrow and for the 31st. Believe on him. If you've been struggling, you can come on down and I can pray with you. Because I don't want there to be a single weak link around here. I don't want there to be a single person around here that could hold us back. We are desiring to walk in the light. It's time to desire for that light. No more playing around. It's no coincidence that the Lord has given us this opportunity. You ought to believe that God has given you the ability to do it. Believe he has given you the power. He has given you the light. Thank you.
pray that anything that's been said or done today has been a blessing to at least one of you. And I truly believe that the victory is already ours. The victory is already ours. You just gotta walk in it. When you wake up tomorrow, walk in it and then run. Come with an expectation that tomorrow the enemy's gonna get a message that we aren't gonna be pushovers like he think we'll be. But we have been equipped. We have been equipped. And we are unashamed of that which we have been equipped with. And we will see freedom. We will see freedom for somebody out there that's in the darkness. Continue to lift up those that are traveling to El Dorado in your prayers. And see freedom and the light shine there as well. I thank you all so much.
Hello, my name is Ryan Colley. I'm International Evangelist and Administrative Vice President of Revival for Christ Club International Ministries. We'd like to thank you so much for tuning into our program today. And if you would like to help us take revival around the world to our friends in Honduras, Mexico, Singapore, and Malaysia, this is how you can do it. First off, you can send in your checks or money orders to 1005 Southwest 4th Street in Moore, Oklahoma, 73160. You can also call in with credit card at 405-793-1777. That's 405-793-1777. And finally, you can do it through the Cash App. That's money sign RFC ROAR. That's money sign RFC ROAR. Thanks in advance for helping us take the flame around the world. Remember, we are a ministry with a vision built on a plan, the Word of God.